Good morning, everyone. I'm Denise Gross, the Executive Director of the Phil Harbert Park Conservancy, and we're here in the park this morning with Adam Tudor, who is going to take us on a musical adventure in nature. And so welcome and thank you for joining us. If you're not familiar with the Phil Harbert Park Conservancy, we are a member-based nonprofit that supports Phil Harbert Park in its programming and in development of the park. So you can join us as a member or just participate in our programs like we're having this morning. So with that, here is Adam and we'll get started.
Woo-hoo! Good morning, friends. Welcome to Imagination Station. This is a place where we learn about music through the eyes of a child. I am so grateful to be with you today. I'm a children's educator and a musician myself. Been a part of the Phil Harberger family for the past couple summers, and super grateful that we have such a beautiful and dedicated team still making this happen amidst these extraordinary times. So I've never done this without an audience, so I'm going to need like to feel like you're really going to have to be super loud and really animated so that I can feel you through the virtual ether of all of this, right? So we're going to make this exciting. We're gonna go on a little walkabout and meet some new animal friends, sing some songs, and do some dances. So I hope that you've got your PJs on or you're flowing or whatever's going on Saturday morning and you're ready to go and make some music. Yeah? All right, let's do this. And I'm gonna be laughing a lot of the time just at the how wild this is. So if you see me laughing, it's not at you, of course. It's at just the entire situation that's happening right now. So I'm so excited. All right, here we go. We like to start out at Imagination Station with our introductions. And so before we can get on the train, we get to Imagination Station by train, usually, we take some time to introduce ourselves. And so we have this roll call that we do together. So if you have your, I invited everybody to have their pots and pans, some shakers, something like that available. If you have that right now, go grab it. If you've got it ready, awesome. So I'm going to do a little example. And then I want to like imagine each one of you doing it. So I'll like pretend to be some of you out there. Maybe I'll imagine your names and we'll do some introductions that way. So,
Adam, actually, if anybody wants to post a comment telling us where you're tuning in from, I can let Adam know so he can hear from you guys as well.
Awesome. Yeah, please. The more interaction, better. The more interaction possible, the better. So, let's get going. So this is my little drum. Maybe you have a little stick around and you can bang a drum or use your hand if you don't have anything. You can just use your hand and your heartbeat. Just like this, we've got a drum inside of us. So, here we go. So we're gonna do our name and our favorite animal, okay? Since we're gonna be meeting some new animal friends in nature and in our stories. So it goes like this. My name is Adam and my favorite animal is a cheetah. I'll go with what I did when I was a little kid. That was always my favorite animal. I got to pet a cheetah once. It's really cool. So, we're going to imagine that you're doing that right now. So, I'll get out some different instruments. And I'm feeling like there is a like lily. I'm just feeling like a lily is out there. So, I'm going to pretend that I'm you, Lily, wherever you are listening. And I'm gonna do your roll call. So here we go.
My name is Lily. Yeah. And my favorite animal is a ladybug.
Awesome, Lily. That was so perfect. I love
Adam,
ladybugs.
Adam, do you have an animal for Drake?
For Drake? I sure do.
She is watching this morning.
Awesome. Okay, Drake.
My name is Trey, and my favorite animal is a unicorn.
Animals can be imaginary or real. But unicorns are real, so I don't know why I said that. So, awesome. Let's do, I know there's some guys out there, so I'm feeling like a Roberto. I'm feeling like Roberto is out there. Or maybe it's Robert. I don't know. Or Rob, or Bob, or Bobby. One of those people is watching. I know. So. My name is Robert, and my favorite animal is a wolf.
Oh!
Hope you're out there, Robert. I hope I got it right. If the universe aligned, then one of those people is watching and has those animals. I know Drake is there, so thank you, Drake, for being with us this morning. I'm waving to you. This is a wave just for you, Drake. So the next part of the imagination station is making sure that we have our most trusted sidekick. All right. Now, he's been asleep for a long time now, so he's a little nervous because he hasn't been out in the world for a long time now. So he's been in quarantine with Mr. Adam this whole time. So he hasn't been outside in a long time. So his skin's a little pale, like if he hasn't gotten a suntan, right? This is my friend Sammy, the saxophone. And Sammy's sleeping, so he's gonna be really quiet. We sing a little song, goes like this. Wake up, Sammy, it's time to play. Wake up, Sammy, it's time to play. I want everybody to do a big yawn. Woo! Oh, and stretch out your arms. All right, so this is Sammy, this is his bot. So we have to put Sammy together though, so. Sammy likes to, kind of like how you all like to take a shower before bed or something like that, or comb your hair. Sammy likes to just take his whole self apart so he can sleep a little easier. So, these are Sammy's pajamas. Whoop! And if you're acting extra crazy, these also act as a tickle torture device. Awesome. So this is Sammy's body. So on top of our body, here's my body. And then next comes my neck. So this is Sammy's neck. So we put this on next. All right. This is Sammy's head. A little bit smaller than mine. And these are Sammy's eyes. So he sees. All right, and this is the most important part. I just dropped it on the floor, but that's okay. Now, I want you to try to imagine talking without your tongue, okay? I want you to try to imagine that.
Can you put your tongue in the back of your mouth like this? Hey, Ben,
he's taking pictures right when I'm making this goofy face.
Harvard, I'm Mr. Arrow.
You can't understand what I'm saying, right? If you don't use your tongue. So, Sammy needs a tongue. It's just a tongue. So we're going to, tastes like chocolate bananas. Anybody want to try? Nobody? Okay. Sometimes I have takers, sometimes I don't. All right. So, we're going to get Sammy, all put together so you all can hear him. Yeah. Do you all want to hear Sammy?
Yeah.
Can I get some whoop whoop? My audience
woo-woo
out there, yeah. It's a man on a bike.
Whoop whoop.
Okay. Mary and Misty are we going to?
Mary and Misty? Fantastic. Hi, Mary.
With you.
Hi, Mary and Misty. Welcome aboard. So glad you're here. All right.
And they're sending hearts.
Sending hearts. Sending hearts back to you. All right. So, it's the moment you've all been waiting for. Let's see if Sammy's not too rusty after all this time. Seems like he's not cooperating right now. I wonder if he's kind of sleepy. He's kind of like, you know how you get when you don't want to wake up in the morning? Maybe that's what's happening. Let me try again. Let me give it one more try. Can y'all cheer me on? Okay, I can feel it. All right, I can do it. I know I can do it. Here we go. It worked! Hooray!
Woo!
Sammy is here to play. So, we're going to start out with a little bit of saxophone language. All right? So, saxophone language. saxophone language is one that you probably have heard somewhere, maybe like in a jazz song or like a cool hip-hop song. Maybe you've never heard it by itself. So, I'm going to teach you some saxophone language. All right? I'm gonna play some things, and then I'm gonna see if y'all can guess it out there, okay? So you gotta type it into the comments if you think you know what I'm saying. All right, here we go. I wonder what that means. Let me do it again. Well, if you didn't guess it, it means, hello, how are you? So that's saxophone for hello, how are you? So we say that to our friends all the time, right? Let's see what else Sammy has up his sleeve. That means that Sammy is really excited to go to Imagination Station. So we have a really, wait. What's that? Oh, okay. He wants to tell you something really, really funny that he just thought of.
Barry thinks he's saying my name is Abe.
My name is Adam? Yeah, that's, it's really, it's very close. It's just one note different, so you're really close. Do you know what that means? I wonder if it's a big, long sentence. Listen again. That's actually saxophone for monkeys. Just that, the whole thing. It just means monkeys. He was tricking you. He likes to be silly sometimes, too. All right, so we have... got some country music playing. In the background, we got some soundtrack, and we've got an audience coming. We got a puppy. Let's show our audience real quick. We've got a beautiful puppy.
This is Bear.
Hi, Bear.
Thanks for joining us, Bear.
14-year-old puppy. Yeah, we've got some friends coming in. That's so awesome. All right, y'all, the moment we've been waiting for. So, this is a very special time. We learned the Imagination Station song. Okay, so if you haven't been singing yet, I want you to warm up your singing voice right now. Okay? La 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 la. I heard you. You guys have really good singing voices. All right. The song goes like this. Let's go to Imagination Station. And it plays on the saxophone like this. So, I need everybody to start marching. Okay, we're gonna imagine like we're on a choo-choo train. So you know how a choo-choo train goes, right? I'm picturing you going like this. Woo-hoo! All right, so. Before we go, one last thing. You need your ticket. So I want to make sure. So who do we have watching right now? We have Misty and Mary and Drake. Do we have anybody else that I've missed?
Jennifer,
okay.
We've got more than one Mary.
More than one Mary, okay, awesome. So I'm going to do a little roll call for you all right? So when I call your name, you're going to say, I'm going to say, Mary, do you have your ticket? And you're going to say, yes, I do. Just like that. Okay. So this is an imaginary ticket. All right. So maybe it's in your pocket. Maybe it's in your hair. Maybe your mom has it or your dad has it. Okay. So I'm going to call it out and then you say, yes, I do. And then we can jump on board. So here we go. Mary, do you have your ticket?
Yes, I do.
All right. We got Mary on board. Okay. Welcome aboard, Mary. We have another Mary. The other Mary, do you have your ticket?
Yes, I do.
All right. We have two Marys on board. Let's see who we're missing. We're missing Drake. Drake, do you have your ticket?
Yes, I do.
All right, Drake, come on in. Who's next? We've got Jennifer. Jennifer, do you have your ticket?
Yes, I do.
All right, Jennifer, come on in. And we have one more person that I just forgot. Misty. Misty, do you have your ticket?
Yes.
Yes, I do. Okay,
Misty. And Amanda.
And Amanda. Cool. I wonder if that's my sister. I think she knew this was happening. If it's Amanda, my sister, you're awesome. If it's not Amanda, my sister, you're still awesome. Okay. Amanda, do you have your ticket?
Yes, I do.
All right. Here we go. So everybody's on board. Let's go to Imagination Station. So we're going to move around a little bit. We gotta go a little bit faster if we're gonna get there on time. The train's about to leave. Here we go. Imagination Station. We can go anywhere we want. And today, we're going to travel across the whole wide world. So we can go visit the animals at the waterhole. I made that a perfect segue so that I could take a drink. All right. So, this is a wonderful book with lots of cool animals in it. So we're gonna practice making some of these animal noises, and I'm gonna try to make the animal noises with the instruments that I have here. And we're just gonna use our imagination. Maybe you can help me at home and you can make the animal noises with them. That would be super awesome. So we're gonna read this little story. It starts out with this one rhino lapping at the waterhole. I wonder what sound a rhino makes. Let me see if I have a rhino sound. I think that's a good rhino. I think that's how a rhino would walk to the waterhole. This is gonna be like if the animals had like their own like boombox, like soundtrack music. That's what I'm gonna be playing. So like this is how the animal walks, real slow and real strong, just like a rhino. Snort, splash, snort, splash. We can also see there's really cool like little frogs that are hanging out. So I want you to notice there's a lot of really cool things in this book. So it's hard to tell from here, but it's got all these hidden animals in the trees and in around the water. So it's a really beautiful book. So I recommend renting, getting it from your local library. All right, moving onwards now. So we started out in Africa. And then where are we now? We've gone to the plains of India. There's two tigers lapping at the waterhole. Grrr. Let's see if we can make some music for the tigers. Mm-hmm. tiger growl out there? Do any ferocious tigers? I can hear, I can feel it. It's really scary. All right. I wonder what's happening next. And I want y'all to watch as the water gets smaller and smaller. And we'll see what happens at the end. Three toucans squawking at the waterhole. Arp, 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 arp. Let me see if I can make that sound on my saxophone. Tropical beat for us. Let's see. Let's see you next. So they were in South America, in Brazil, it looks like. Now we're traveling to the Himalayan Mountains in Nepal. And we have four snow leopards gazing at them. Maybe you've heard your little cat purr. It's kind of like that, but a little bit bigger. Maybe we can do a capper with my saxophones. There's a little leopard there. So now we're gonna go from India. Oh! There's Mount Rushmore. We've traveled back to the United States. And there are five moose bellowing at the waterhole. Let's see what kind of sound a moose makes. If you ever traveled to Yellowstone National Park, if you've seen a moose in real life, or to Colorado. I think we're still in the great United States. Looks like we're probably in New Orleans. Some catfish, six catfish floundering in the water. Let's see if we can have a little, I know, we'll play a little New Orleans song. All right, so we need to go get on the road again. It's time to travel all the way. Look what's happening, though, to the waterfall. How small it's getting. We've traveled all the way to China. Look at these pretty pandas. They're all trying to find some water. I wonder. Some of them look kind of sad. Looks like there's not enough. Let me see. A little panda sound. Getting a little bit sad. The pandas are weepy. The water hole is disappearing. Eight ladybugs buzzing around the water hole. Zip, zip, zip. I don't know what sound. I know somebody had a ladybug as their favorite animal. So maybe they know the sound of ladybug makes. You can tell me if I make a good ladybug sound. Let me see. That's a man. Imagine they're flying around somewhere. Okay, let's see who's next. Nine tortoises lumbering around the waterhole. Look, the water's almost gone. No! what sound a tortoise makes. Kind of like the rhinos, it's really slow. Lastly, 10 kangaroos. And there's no water left. The water hole. Oh, no. All the animals went away. All the life died. There's no water. Water is the source of life. But wait. There was a drop of rain. And there was some thunder in the distance. Whoa! Saw some amazing lightning. And it kept raining and raining and raining and raining. It rained so much. Look at all that rain. Hi, friend. All of a sudden, all the animals are back. Woohoo! Yippee! Yay! And everybody was happy. So, we are now going to go on a special adventure. We're going to go. I heard that the animals were having a dance party, but it's at a special spot in the wilderness. Because they're celebrating the water being back. So if you're down for a little adventure with me, I'd like to go hang out with the animals maybe, and we can have like a little dance party. And that sounds like the funnest idea I've had in a long time. So. Y'all ready to come along? Let's get going. I'm probably gonna meet some friends along the way. Good morning, friends.
Good morning.
Going on a nature walk. Coming that way. Let's keep going. We're getting close. So I'm so excited to be with y'all right now. And I've been to this party before, and it's a really special gathering of friends. So I hope that you all like to dance. We're gonna be doing lots of dancing. We're gonna go this way. I hear it. All right, here we go. We're getting so close, guys. Good morning. We're gonna sing a little song to get ready. It goes like this. You repeat after me, okay? We're going on a nature walk.
Going on a nature walk.
We're gonna find some new friends.
Going to find some new friends.
We're going on a nature walk.
Going on a nature walk.
I don't want it to win.
I don't want it to win.
We're going on a nature walk.
Going on a nature walk.
We're gonna make some new friends.
Gonna make some new friends.
We're going on a nature walk.
Going on a nature walk.
I don't want it to win.
I don't want it to win.
I feel like we're getting really close.
be really quiet. On the road to the party. They must be going to the party too. Are you guys going to the nature party?
The nature party?
It's gonna be so much fun.
Is it?
Oh my gosh. Part of being in nature? We're being extra quiet right now. Wait, did you hear that? Guys, I heard a lion. I don't know. I don't know if I can do it. You think I can?
Yeah.
Yeah. Be brave. I heard some monkeys too, guys. Oh, wow. This is the real deal. We're going on a nature walk.
Going on a nature walk.
We're gonna find some new friends.
Going on a new friend.
Going on a nature walk.
Going on a nature walk.
I don't want it to end.
Don't want it to end.
Right, yeah, we're almost there. Oh, I see the party happening. Oh, this is exciting, guys. You can't hear, but all the animals are cheering for us. They're all cheering us on.
And that's the party's that way, friends. You're going the wrong way.
Perfect. It's the perfect place for a party. All right. Never been to this park before. So this is where, so the animals are telling me that this is a good place for the musician to set up. So we're gonna, for the DJ, so they've been waiting for their DJ for quite a while now. All right, so. We're gonna be learning about lots of different kinds of dances. Because we're reading a book called Giraffes Can't Dance. And you'll be able to tell that this is also kind of an autobiographical work of my life. Because I'm very tall and sometimes people think I dance funny. But we'll see who's victorious at the end of this book. So, getting ready for our dance party. Here we go. So I'm gonna get the music queued up. Started with the party.
When we bow our slumber.
right now than Africa. Gerald was a tall giraffe whose neck was long and slim, but his knees were awfully crooked and his legs were rather thin. He was very good at standing still and munching shoots off trees. But when he tried to run around, he buckled at the knees. Poor Gerald, I've been there before. Now every year in Africa, they hold the jungle dance, where every single animal turns up to skip and prance. And this year when the day arrived, poor Gerald felt so sad, because when it came to dancing, he was really very bad. The warthogs started waltzing. It's Pumbaa. And the rhinos rock and roll. The lions danced a tango that was elegant and bold. Gerald found a little clearing and he looked up at the sky. Excuse me, coughed Cricket. He'd seen Gerald earlier on. But sometimes when you're different, you just need a different song. Listen to the swaying grass and listen to the trees. To me, the sweetest music is those branches in the breeze. So imagine that the lonely moon is playing just for you. Everything makes music if you really want it to. It's very beautiful words from this cricket. Everything makes music if you really want it to. Remember that. With that, the cricket smiled and picked up his violin. Then Gerald felt his body do the most amazing thing. His hooves had started shuffling, making circles on the ground. His neck was gently swaying, and his tail was swishing round. I'm imagining the music was something like this. He threw his legs out sideways, and he swung them everywhere. Then he did a backward somersault and leapt up in the air. Wow. Extraordinary. Gerald felt so wonderful. His mouth was open wide. I am dancing. Yes, I am dancing. I am dancing, Gerald cried.
Sure.
Then one by one, each animal who'd been there at the dance arrived while Gerald boogied on and watched him, quite entranced. They shouted, "It's a miracle! We must be in a dream! Gerald's the best dancer that we've ever, ever seen!" Now the animals have changed their tune, pun intended. "How did you learn to dance like that? Please, Gerald, tell us how!" But Gerald simply twirled around and finished with a bow. Then he raised his head and looked up at the moon and stars above. "We all can dance," he said, "when we find music that we love." So good. So, we're going to find some music that we love right now. And we're going to have a little dance party. So I'm going to lead us in some different music from all around the world. This first one.
Oh, you don't. Boy, if I
have lived this evening. Slow jazz one. You get a little rocket. Did you guys stand on your toes like this? You like your tippy toeing. Just like this, and you can come. You step back a little bit. Going somewhere. Take your finger up like this in the air. Taste it. It's in the air. Just rock back and forth. Maybe your mom or dad or your sister or brother. You can dance with them a little back and forth. It's a good summertime song. I know you guys are ready to move a little bit more. Here's a good San Antonio song. You want to move your feet extra fast for this one. Starts with the feet. And next, get your hips into it. Start to lean back and forth. Then you can walk. You can twirl around. This is a good one if you have any like scarves around, anything billowy. This one we're going to kind of connect with the spirit of nature. I want you to imagine like you're a little gypsy, maybe an Aladdin or something. Imagine you're moving the wind with your hands. Get your hips into it like a little genie. Back to Texas. This is another good one if you got a friend nearby and you want to grab them and do a little two-step. Never done it, goes just two steps.
Maybe all I got is this beat up
leather. Let me remember how to do it myself.
And everything I own don't fill up half. Don't you worry about the way I pack.
You can twirl your partner like this, send him back around.
Maybe
do a little lasso of your little brother.
I'm carrying your love with me. West Virginia down to Tennessee.
Do a little line dance.
I'll be moving with the good Lord sweet. Carrying your love with me.
All right. It's time. The animals seem to be slowly going home around here. I think it's time that we head back to home base for our final song. So for this walk back, I want you to close your eyes. I want you to travel to where this music is from. We're in the rainforest of Central America. So I want you to close your eyes. And we're just going to come down a little bit and be still. We're going to see if we can feel the spirit of the trees around us. Gonna listen to the music all around us. Having fun, be sure to let us know how you're doing out there. Give us a little thumbs up or tell us tell us what you're liking. Do you like the songs? Do you want to hear some more saxophone? Let me know what you guys are feeling out there. I'd love to hear from you. Same way that Sammy can talk, even though he's not a real person, if you take the time to listen, very closely, the trees will talk to you too. Next time you're at the park, don't just listen for the animals. Listen for the trees too. Listen for the plants and the flowers, even the smallest little insects. The tree says thank you for listening. All right, we're almost back home. Sometimes the most fun part of music are the spaces in between the notes. This is a place where we get to be with the spirit of nature, that which we cannot see, that which we cannot hear. It's still there. Next time you want to dance and there's no music around, maybe just listen to the music in your soul, in your heart, and just imagine what that's like. Busy day today at the park. Many friends have come out to listen to the voice of nature, to breathe her fresh air. There's so much that Mother Nature gives us. Sometimes it's important that we just say thank you. Really what we're saying when we're quiet and we're listening. Sometimes we don't have to say it out loud. Looks like we're back home, friends. We got one more little song for you. Come this way.
This is my friend Gibby the guitar. Gibby wasn't here last time because I hadn't found him yet. He's a new member to the musical family. So we're gonna sing a little song, so I wanna know who's still out there in the audience.
Christy.
Mary. I think it is my family. That's my mom. I think Little Mary's is my mom. Hey, Mom, if it's you, you should comment and say something.
Well, Amanda says it's been a great reminder of the many ways we can enjoy nature.
That is my sister, totally.
And Anna Marie is watching from Wimberley.
Oh, beautiful. Hi, Anne-Marie. Thanks for tuning in all across Texas. So I'm feeling a little bit quieter now, so I'm just going to make up a little song for all my friends that have been watching.
Thanks to Misty and Mary and Amanda too, to the other Mary and Jennifer too. We had another friend, I think her name was Drake. I wanna go jump in a really, really cool lake. Feels nice right now. Thank you for coming today. Thank you. It was fun to play.
I wanna thank Hardburger Park. That's a mouthful to say in a song. I want to thank my friends Denise and Teresa for following me all day long. I want to thank each and every one of you for joining me on this adventure. I hope that had a beautiful time. Hope it's not the last time that we see each other.
Thank you for coming today. Thank you. It was fun to play. If you had so much fun, stay in touch. www.adam-tutor.com. Something that rhymes with touch. Feel free to message me on
Facebook or Instagram. I'm happy to make the time to play with you wherever I am. Thank you for coming today. Thank you. It was fun to play. Thank you, friends. Have a beautiful day, and thank you so much for coming to Imagination Station. I hope to meet you all at some more of our summer camps. There's some more things happening this summer in the coming weeks, so you can message me, check out my Facebook page, my website, and find out more about that. And please stay in touch. Thank you so much to Hardberger Park Conservancy, Teresa and Denise, and all the friends who made this possible and provide this beautiful space for us to come out. So next time you're in nature, be sure to listen, be sure to say thank you, and give a hug to a fellow tree or a plant that you see. So much joy to find you. Thank you. Blessings.